Hello, and thank you for returning to Wildstar's History of Nexus. In Chapter 7, we will begin a tale about Sirik Brightlin and the history and origins of a very famous ship in Wildstar. Chapter 7, Part 3, A Desperate Gamble. Brightlin grimly surveyed the battle screens as his 5 seconds trickled away. Finally, he sighed. "Permission to come aboard, then, I guess. Hand you my sword." He brought the Star of Dominus about and set a course for the flagship.
"You're doing the right thing, Commander," Erlewis said into his ear.
"I think so, too."
And he unleashed his ship's entire arsenal upon the Radiant. Stabbing a button to silence Erlewis's growl of fury, Sirik bathed the massive flagship in violet geysers. Then Erlewis returned fire. Every battery blazed, engulfing Brightland's ship in ghostly zero-G flame. Beyond, Exile's spin drivers flashed one by one as the ships winked out. "Maybe we'll make it after all," Sirik thought right before another volley from Radiant flung him into first one wall, then another, before a sliver of bubbling metal speared his lung from behind. Blinking away blood, he gazed at the sole remaining display showing his relentless collision course, already too close for the Radiant's widely spaced cannon turrets to track. Brightlin leaned on his console and hailed the flagship. His brain felt fuzzy and heavy. He meant to say something about the uncertainty of losing hands, but all he managed was,
"This isn't over, Erlewis."
The Dominion captain regarded him impassively.
"It is for you, traitor."
Chunks of hull plating flew from the two ships as they hurtled toward impact. Dimly, Brightlin heard his voice mumbling a slurred command to jump. He blinked and suddenly found himself in a med bay, an impossibly young girl with ensign piping leaning over him.
"Where am I?"
he croaked. He couldn't feel his limbs.
"With the fleet, sir. We escaped. We need orders."
"The ship?"
"The Dominus is being refitted, sir. It'll be ready in a week."
"Call it the Gambler's Ruin,"
Sirik whispered.
Then the void enveloped him.